myself is better not said. Now I'm closer to the edge. It was a thousand to one and a million to two. Time to go down in flames and I'm taking you closer to the edge.
Straight. Same thing again. Back to the slalom. Slalom like this. Look nice far ahead. Can the corners go? That's it. Doesn't matter. 10 bits there. It's just like I say, they're done. Yeah. But how to simulate this. And I mean, you can do as fast as you want, as slow as you want, at your comfortable pace.
Can I come back?
Like same thing when you're two, making a U-turn. Same yeah. Principle, my left hand comes off and goes to the top of the stairs. Nice 90 degree bend in your arm. When you're going through a high speed or a corner as such, it doesn't have to be high speed, you want the best control of the car. If your arms have a 90 degree bending, when you turn to the corner, your elbow still bends. Okay? If you're too far away or the steering wheel's too far away, when you're turning, you actually extend your arm to its full and you've got no control in the car. That's why we always have a bend. It's easier to do this and this. Yeah. Okay, good.
Because I'm Stephen Lancaster from Kingfisher FM. And this is an Audi A6 Quattro, lovely vehicle to drive. Just starting the experience and so excited about what we've learned so far.
This is crossover, try practice technique. You're not sure, you can stop dead on the course to get your bearings. Remember,
get ready.
Whichever way you're turning, the bottom hand comes off.
looks like from the outside. Let's have a look at the braking here. Hey, dead people! Dead people, come this way. That's what 120 looks like from the outside. Let's look at the braking, guys. That's what 160 looks like from the outside. Look at the braking now. Right. So, okay, 100 meters, no problem. 160 k's an hour, off you go. What do you reckon if it was raining here today?
Maybe double.
Okay. Right, so if it was raining here today, we would still be standing here. We'd be standing with umbrellas. We carry on in the rain. Nothing's happened. You're looking at about 20% more. It's about 20 meters extra. It's nothing. It's not that bad. What do you reckon if it was raining at 160 with a non-ABS car?
Oh, shit.
He's actually right. Probably inside those tires over there. If you can, keep the thing straight because the thing's locking up also in all kinds of directions. This is 100. You run out of space. Now, just one misunderstanding about ABS. ABS, people reckon that will stop you quicker. So this exercise, 160 took this car roughly 100 meters to stop. What do you reckon if we did the same thing with the City Golf, but we put Michael Schumacher in the car? Which car do you think would stop quicker? Schumacher in a City Golf or Gary in an Audi?
Gary in an Audi,
yeah. Everyone thinks that's the case. It's not the case, guys. You can stop quicker with a non-ABS car. The reason I said Schumacher, Schumacher's got that sensitivity to start braking and prevent it from locking up. Hold it at the utmost pace just before it starts locking up, just before it goes outside the tire grip circle.